Bob Goodlatte, House Judiciary Committee. Great to see you today, Chairman. Boy, you are right in the middle of this breaking news right now. Talk to me about this letter that has gone back with these other options that you're looking at with regard to Lisa Page.
So, Harris, it's great to be with you and your viewers. And it does appear that Lisa Page apparently has something to hide. She has been in complete defiance of cooperation with the House Judiciary Committee and the Oversight and Government Reform Committee for 7 months now, dating back to the first letter we wrote to the Department of Justice in December of last year asking for her appearance. There have been two subsequent letters and two subpoenas issued for her appearance, and she has defied all of that. Now, when she says that she has not had ample time to prepare, that is belied by those facts. In addition, our attorneys have had communications with her attorney for nearly a month now about this appearance, and her attorney agreed to accept service of the subpoena and then turned around and immediately tried to reject it. So that's why we sent the marshals to her house to serve the subpoena. They had to go back three times before they finally were able to reach her and serve the subpoena on her. So this is a very serious matter. This subpoena is still in effect. I think it's very important for her to understand that, and she should comply with it, and she should comply with it now before she's held in contempt of Congress, which could happen as soon as Friday.
And Chairman, you and I have talked about this before. I hear a difference in your voice. I understand the urgency, and it's somewhat on her behalf. And this situation, it seems like it's changing as well from Catherine Herridge's reporting. I mean, it's going to be a very different room if she has to sit next to her lover, Peter Strzok. I mean, how much under consideration would it be to put those two together? It was their text messages together that got us to where we are.
Well, that's certainly one option that she has. Another is to still appear for the voluntary interview that we originally offered her, or to comply with the subpoena for a deposition. But she's got to do it fast. She does not have days or weeks to do this. She's got to decide now whether she's going to cooperate or not, because we will hold her in contempt, and that's a serious matter.
You know, I'm curious, what is leadership at the FBI saying? We had Tom Homan, former deputy director for ICE, on last hour on Outnumbered, and he said, as former law enforcement, it's her duty to do this. She has to go and testify before you. He said that's part of her responsibility. I'm curious, what is Christopher Wray? What are others at the FBI saying at this moment? Have you spoken to them?
They want her to testify. I spoke with the general counsel of the FBI earlier this morning, Dana Bente. He says they want her to testify. They reached out to her, in fact, when she says the documents weren't made available. They reached out to her to let her know, hey, you've got a deposition. Don't you want to come in and examine documents? So finally, after that was done, she went down there at 3 o'clock yesterday afternoon, did examine documents for a few hours. There was a glitch, a computer glitch, with regard to classified documents, plus the fact that her classified status, her security status, had to be reinstated so she could examine classified materials.
That was done.
And later that evening, the computer glitch was solved. And we know that because we know other witnesses went in and examined classified materials. So we think that is simply an excuse for not appearing. We think it's inexplicable. And we think she needs to comply with this subpoena, and she needs to do it immediately.
All right. I know this may be very detailed for some of our viewers, but I want them to understand. At first, Strzok and Page removed from those investigations that they had so much power in at the FBI, but not from their jobs. And so there was a question from people like Senator Rand Paul, well, do they retain their security clearances? For a period, we know at least they would have. But what you're saying now is that now she's had to have it reinstated so that she can look at these documents. Last thought from you about what you think you can get from her that you haven't already heard.
Well, first of all, with regard to the security clearance issued, she left her employment with the FBI in April or May of this year, and her her security clearance ended at that time. So it did need to be reinstated. It was reinstated, by the way, before Peter Strzok came in for his private interview. a couple of weeks ago, and reinstated again for the purpose of his appearance before the committee tomorrow so that he could go in and examine documents that he wanted to examine in preparation for his hearing. But we think that Lisa Page can be very helpful to the Congress and through
Senator,
the Congress, to the American people
in
shedding light on what was happening.
Forgive me for stepping in. We're about to get hit by a commercial. I apologize.
Sure.